What is up, guys? In this video, we're going to show you every single maneuver on the UK driving test. I recently did a poll on YouTube and I asked you guys, who's the better driver, me or Laura?
Blatantly me.
So let's have some fun with this. We're going to go head to head. I'm going to show you the technique I use for a maneuver and Laura's going to show you the technique she uses for the maneuver. Let us know which one you like the best. Let us know who's the best at parking. You ready?
I was born ready.
All right, let's go.
Also, your driving instructor might be teaching you a different method for these maneuvers, but find a technique that works for you.
Good point.
So good.
Okay, because we're in Wingyip, which is, if you know me, my favorite place on earth.
We didn't just have Wingyip, did we?
No, we haven't just had Wingyip, but I'm trying to convince Laura that we need to go after this video.
Whoever parks the most rubbish has to pay for Wingyip.
Okay, cool. Yes. Chinese food for life. Let's go. Forward bay parking first. Ready?
I'm ready.
Off you go.
Let me at least come out the bay first.
If you do this on your driving test, the examiner is going to drive you into a car park and ask you to forward park into any bay of your choice. So, Laura, when you're ready, off you go.
So, I think I'm going to choose a bay on the right-hand side.
Why?
Just because I prefer it.
Okay.
So, I'm going to start as far to the left as possible. And what I tend to do is, if you're choosing a bay on the right, imagine it's a road on the right and just go for it.
A road on the right, explain more.
Imagine you're turning from a major road into a minor road.
Right, and you want to keep your car close to the curb.
And you want to keep close to, yeah, exactly okay. That.
Nice.
Can we just check that out first, please? Like, should we measure like how perfect that is? Like that's smack bam in the middle of the bay.
Now, reverse out when you're ready.
Okay, so when you're reversing out, you need to take a mental note if you're in a car park, which is a one-way car park, so you know which way to reverse out.
Cool.
This is a one-way car park. You've been here plenty of times to know. It's a one-way car park. Let me just check around. I'm going to come out about halfway out of the bay first before I start any steering, just for in case there was a car parked next to me. I don't want to reverse back
too
far.
But there isn't a car park next to you.
There isn't, but I don't want to reverse back far enough that I'm going to hit anything behind me either. Ta-da!
Cool. How did Laura do with that? Did your instructor teach it any differently? Let's see how I do it. Swap seats. Okay, my turn. And I have to drive this
bloody car. Now it's Ron's turn.
Let's drive on.
Bloody car.
Does the handbrake turn off by itself? Yes. Okay, so I'm just entered the car park and my examiner's told me to find a bay of my choice and park in it. So I'm not going to take too long about this. I'm not going to keep driving till I find a bay. I'm just going to pick one that's really close to me. I'm going to stop. I'm going to choose a bay on the right as well, but that's because I'm already far away from it. If I was on the left of the car park, I'm going to choose a bay on the right. Start as far away from the bay as possible so that you've got a little bit of wiggle room. If you start too close, you're going to steer into the bay, hit the end before you're parallel. So I've just stopped in the car park. I'm going to choose my bay now because I'm not in a rush with this. You get about 4 minutes to do this maneuver. Absolutely ages, don't rush it. I've stopped there. I've lined up the line, the first line of my bay that I want to get into, with my feet. So the line is now running underneath my feet, imaginarily. Is that a word?
Yeah, you kind of want to imagine that white line is completely painted across okay. That as if it's coming through your car.
Yeah. And that's perfect. Next thing, the other reason why I want to stop is so that I can take a proper check around the car like Laura didn't. If I'm stopped, if I'm driving slowly or I've got L plates on and I'm in a car park, the car behind me, who's a proper driver, who's on his way to get shopping, is probably going to overtake you. If you didn't check, you didn't see him. Then I'm going to signal to let everyone know what I'm doing next. And we're going to set off really slowly, just clutch control, no brakes needed. I'm not going to use the brakes as well as the clutch because then I'm going to be really, really, really
close to the right.
Really jerky and not smooth with my speed at all. Let's have a look at that. Handbrake, neutral. perfect first time?
I mean, it's not as central as what mine was in the bay. That is a technique that I use when I'm teaching as well. I was just trying to give something different.
Okay, cool.
It's just ensuring that you've got enough space.
It's also ensuring that you look around before you do a big turn.
Yeah, change
in direction.
Did I not look?
No, you didn't.
Yeah, I do teach. Hey guys, come on, back me up. I teach you guys to look, don't I?
Okay, I'm just going to work out which way my arrow is. And this is something that people find confusing as well. Which way do I need to steer? Okay, so if I'm driving forwards, I'm steering the front of the car. If I steer left, the car's going to go left. If I steer right, the car's going to go right. Just think of it, instead of opposite. I know some people teach that. It's so confusing. It confuses me too. I'm now steering the back of the car because I'm in reverse. So if I want the back of the car to go left, I'll steer left. If I want the back of the car to go right, I'll steer right.
You're still steering the direction you want the car to travel.
I need to drive that way. Yeah, cool. So I'm going to start reversing. Handbrake's on. Stupid car. The back of the car goes right. I'm just going to keep looking around. And for me, I want to reverse backwards until I'm parallel with the road and then straighten up. Because then I don't have to mess about doing any quick steering when I set off. My maneuver's done and I'm going to drive on. Oh, that was pressure, you know.
It's pressure, it's pressure, isn't it? And you fucked it up the first time.
No, I didn't.
You did.
Cool. So, Forward Bay Park, tick in the box. That's really easy. It's one of the best maneuvers you can get on your driving test for sure. Next, we're going to do reverse bay parking, and people really freak out about this. It's not that difficult though, is it?
It's not difficult. No. I love reverse bay parking. It's one of my favourite things to teach. I've had so many people come to me in the past and be like, I just can't do it. I just can't end up between the
and
lines.
Then make it make sense.
And within a couple of minutes, it make sense. They're in and they're just like, right, can we go to the supermarket?
Brilliant. Brilliant. And if you do this on your driving test, it's going to be from the test centre car park. So you will have already parked in a bay with your instructor backwards. The examiner will tell you to drive off from this bay and reverse back into any bay. There's no requirement to do it from 90 degrees. You can do 45 degrees. The examiner can't tell you what bay to pick and they can't tell you what technique to do. So if you're learning with your mum, dad, use their technique. If you're learning with friends, family, do whatever they do. But we're going to show you the technique that we use to teach people. So, examiner, what should I do? Drive off and pick a bay?
So yeah, if you'd like to exit from this bay and choose a bay to reverse into.
I'm going to do really good observation because that's mainly the main thing that the driving test is all about.
Why are you turning left? We're in a one-way
car park. Oh no! We are in a one-way car park, so I have to go this way. What I would advise you to do though, if you're on your driving test, the driving test centers never normally have one-way car parks. Luckily, we've got bays both sides, but I would recommend you turn out to the left because this is much easier doing it left than right. So, doesn't matter whether we're far or close to the bay on this one, it works either way. So, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna line up my shoulder with a line. That'll get me two bays back. Got my shoulder lined up with the line. I'm gonna go into reverse, boom, done. Really good observation. It doesn't matter if you're really good at parking. What matters is that you're safe at parking. Set off nice and slow. Full turn to the left. Don't know why she's laughing. Why did that not work? Fuck off. No, it did, it did. I'm in. There we
just
go.
Just about.
Turn. All right, I'm going to do it again. Jesus, does that not work in your car? Is this?
Got a shoulder, though.
No. Shoulder doesn't work in your car?
Got a shoulder, nope.
Why? Hmm? Why? Because it's got mad amounts of steering lock. Shoulder doesn't work.
Well, you
know that one, and it doesn't work in your car. Is that why you're looking at me like that?
Yes, I'm just waiting for you to talk about how you would do it. We're head to head here, remember?
All right, cool.
We're head to head here. You're currently losing.
Well, I'm gonna do the shoulder method again because it should work. And if it doesn't work, it'll be for one of a few things. Maybe your car has more of a turning circle than another car, but it's gonna be about the speed of your steering and the speed of your car. So if you're ending up too far to the left, slow down your steering. If you're ending up too far to the right, speed up your steering. This is just a reference point, a point to start from, so that it happens the same every time. Think of it like a recipe. If you have the same ingredients, bake it at the same temperature, it comes out exactly the same. So we're gonna start here, at my shoulder. I'm persevering with this method.
However, there's variables to this method because depending on your seated position, if you're sat close and further forward.
Always works. You just need to speed up or slow down the steering. And once you do it a few times, you'll find out how fast to steer. So I know that I finished too far to the left, so I'm gonna slow down my steering. Checking all around. And I'm gonna steer. A little bit more slowly than I did last time.
A little bit too much reliability on that mirror, in my opinion.
Why?
More observations needed.
Because you've got that mirror. If you didn't have that mirror like I don't, I wouldn't be using it. And yeah, you're right. You do need to be checking around. Don't look at the mirror, because once you've committed to the turn, you can't change it anyway. So don't look at the mirror. If you don't end up in the bay, you just correct it with good observation. Bob's your uncle.
Fanny's your aunt.
I'm in the bay. So test and adjust. If it's not working for you and you're getting too close to the left every time, then you're doing it right. You just need to adjust one of the variables. If you get too far to the right, speed up your steering. Too far to the left, slow down your steering.
Yeah, it's a combination. It's the speed of the car versus the speed of the steering.
Your turn. Show us how to park in this stupid car. God, I hate Peugeot. All right, go for it. Drive on and find a bay to park in, please.
Okay, I am also going to choose one on the left. However, I'm going to use a different technique. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to look towards my target bay. So the bay that I want to end up in, I'm going to look in that direction. Because that also...
Can't turn this off.
No, you can't turn it off. Leave it alone.
But you can.
Sorry, back to inappropriate behaviour, touching. Stop.
You really can't turn that off.
What, the camera?
Yeah.
No, you can't turn the camera off.
No, you're going to cheat.
I'm not going to cheat at all. I'm not going to cheat at all. So by looking in the direction of your target bay, you're looking in the direction of where you want to travel as well. So as well as looking around and making sure it's safe, what you want to do is you want to come back until you can see the line that's going to end up to your left in the corner of your back passenger window. When it's in the corner of your back passenger window, we are going to steer in and we're going to look all around. Yeah. And then when we are parallel to the lines, we are going to straighten up and back it up and making sure that you are still... looking all around.
I like that. That's really good.
Can we just measure the distance again between the lines, please? Is that 2-0?
No. You didn't even check your mirror before you went in forward. Definitely not 2. Guys, comment. Who's winning? Who's won? Who's the best at parking? All right, that's a perfect space. Let's pull up on the left behind the white car. Awesome. This looks like the perfect spot to do some parallel parking. So if you do this on your driving test, your examiner is going to ask you to pull up on the left and then get you to drive on and reverse park back into the space. Ready?
Ready.
Let's see how you do this.
Okay, so I'm going to prepare the car. Now I'm going to observe all Great. Around.
Good shot.
Start from my least important side, work around to my most important side, deciding does anyone need a signal, no one's around to benefit from that, and then I'm going to pull up nice and straight and parallel to the curb. I don't want to be too close that I'm going to knock off his mirror, nor do I want to be too far away that I'm taking up the whole road. Once I'm here, I'm going to put it into reverse. Reverse lights are your signal for anything behind, for them to know what it is that you're about to do.
So you wouldn't signal left?
I wouldn't signal left unless there was anybody... like him now, I'm sat here, he can't see my reverse lights, so I'm showing him my signal so he knows that I'm here. Now I don't need my signal no more.
Okay.
Then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna reverse back until I can see some space behind that car. Now it doesn't matter which way round that car is parked, whether it's the bonnet end that end or the boot end that end, I wanna see clear space behind that car. So the end of that car is probably gonna come to about halfway in the window, okay? I like to work lock to lock because I like to think of not just your test, I like to think of after you've passed your test, the reality of parallel parking is that you're going to want to end up between two cars.
Close cars.
So now I'm here, I'm going to check around again before I start and I'm going to lock the wheel and get going. Now when I'm parallel to the car, I'm facing 12 o'clock on a clock. I want to get to about a 2 o'clock position, which is about a 45 degree angle. By using this technique, you're keeping your head up and you're kind of looking around as you're going whilst you're determining your angle. When you get to where 2 o'clock is on a clock, you're going to lock it back the other way, making sure that you're still looking all around, stopping for anything. And then when you are parallel to the curb, you're going to take your lock back off.
That was slick. And look how much space you've used up. Because you did lock to lock, full lock left, full lock right, that helps you to use less space.
Now, with some of my pupils, I would say to them, some of my pupils who have got real good reversing experience and can control the car really well when reversing, I tell them, right, we're going to start there, and I just want you to get the car here and watch how they do it. Like all the manoeuvres, there's no specific technique. It's whatever works for you.
Yeah, cool. Let's swap seats.
Let's my do turn. It.
All right, let's go. Okay, I'm going to give you a slightly different method and slightly different methodology. I'm definitely going to check around before I do anything, because that's important on your driving test.
Extremely important.
Instant fail if you don't do that. I'm going to signal because I can't see what's in any of these cars. There might be someone there thinking about pulling off at the same time as me. If we're both not signaling, we're both going to have a problem. So I'm going to pull up alongside this car. Not too close, like Laura said, not too far away. I'm going to put my gear into reverse so that this car behind knows exactly what I'm about to do. And as a guide, if I can swing the passenger door all the way open, I'm too far away. If I can't squeeze out, you're too close. Or if Laura can't squeeze out, I'm too close. Or if Laura can pop the door a little bit and jump out, show them, then I'm a perfect distance away. Can you throw that door all the way open? Are you gonna smash into that really expensive BMW?
I will smash into that really expensive BMW, and then we'll need to get out of here.
We'll need to run. Great, so I'm in a perfect starting position, nice and parallel as well. I'm gonna go into reverse gear and check around a lot before I start reversing. That's important, isn't it?
It's hugely important to make sure you're looking all around.
You probably
around.
Teach your students that, but you just didn't do it.
Did I not? I did you do it!
Didn't do a full check before you started reversing.
I did!
Game over, instant fail.
I did!
Bloody didn't. Watch this video when I put it out. Now there's all the cars gone past me. I'm gonna do another check. If it's been a couple of seconds since you last checked, check again. And same as Laura, I'm gonna check to make sure that the back of the car is in my back passenger window, and then we're gonna take one turn to the left. I'm gonna let this car go past me first. Nope, doesn't wanna go past. And we're gonna take one turn to the left. Reason being, okay, you might wanna do this in real life and park between two tight cars, but we're on a driving test, and actually you get the space of minimum two car lengths. So I don't need to turn full lock to the left. I can just do this at a shallow angle, which means you can be less accurate with your steering. It's much easier.
Oh, nice front blind spot check eventually.
Go on.
Should you be waving people past like that?
Gonna cut this out, so what else?
Why do you always cut out the bit saying you fuck up?
It's my I do the edits.
Go on, it's my job.
I do the edits, so yeah. Right, so next what I'm gonna look for is, do you know what, that's funny, I'm just probably gonna leave it in. So whatever. I always say that, don't I? When I say I'm going to cut something out, it's more funny than to leave it in. I should just say I'm broke. I should just stay quiet. Anyway, what I'm next looking for is the mirror to show me a pizza slice. A nice slice of, there it is. Nice slice of pizza. So the curb, the car, and the bottom of the mirror are making a triangle. It's easier to remember if we call it a slice of pizza, but it is a triangle.
But does not that matter how big your pizza is and how big a slice of pizza you
when
like to eat?
When the back of the car connects with the curb, it makes a triangle. When the back of the car hasn't connected with the curb, it's not a triangle.
Okay.
Call it a slice of pizza. It sounds more fun. Domino's? Papa John's?
Cake instead?
Which one do you go for?
Red velvet.
I know you don't like pizza, but...
Red velvet choose, or cheesecake?
Choose one. We're not going red for a slice of cake. I don't like cake and you don't like pizza. This is spicy doomed pepperoni. To fail. So I've got my pizza slice. I'm taking my two turns to the right. And boom, stop. Turn left to straighten up. Handbrake, neutral. That was stressful.
Nice method. And the distance between you and the BMW now is a bit further. It's greater than what mine was. Mine can be altered. The greater space that you can see behind the car will enable you to have more space when you're finishing. So
it's not wrong to do all the way or one turn left. It's just easier. The examiner's going to ask me to pull away next, so I've got more space to do that.
Both really good methods.
They are good. So Laura's is the one you're going to use after you pass your driving test, and mine's the one they're going to use while you're on your driving test because it's easier and safer and stuff.
However, the result of my parking was a little bit close to the curb than yours. So I think
so close to the curb that on the first attempt you bumped the curb.
That's what makes it 3-0.
But remember,
3-0 to Laura.
On your driving test, keep that safety margin. You have a safety margin. You can finish up over.
You can be a drained
width.
You can be a drained width from the curb.
So if you're trying to park super close to the curb, like that BMW is in front, you're not giving yourself that safety margin. You're putting yourself in danger because you might bump the curb by accident, which isn't a fail.
It's not there.
Plus, it's not a fail. It's just a minor who won that one. No, because mine's for the driving test.
Yeah, but we're teaching people out here to drive for the rest of their lives.
Well, it's not hard to add on a little bit more steering, no, but exactly. On a driving test, get your
method.
Safety.
So with that method, it's good because you can add or subtract.
Okay, I tell you what, guys, this is down to you. We've shown you 3 manoeuvres so far. Next is going to be pull up on the right, which is the easiest manoeuvre in the world. Do we even need to do that? Yeah, let's do it, because this is a video for every single manoeuvre. But mine's obviously the better method. So guys, get in the comments, show some love.
I would love to make you reverse around the corner like old school times.
It's not on the driving test. And it's the most pointless manoeuvre. Why are we practicing reversing around the corner? When am I ever going to do that?
It's in order to change direction.
Yeah, but I don't have to reverse around the corner. I could just reverse into a junction and drive off again. I don't have to do it so close to the... Even when teaching it, I could never justify why I was teaching it to you. Why are we doing this? Don't know. It's just on a driving test. Go for it. Isn't it? Like, what? So dumb. All right, let's drive on and we'll find somewhere to pull up on the right. Boom! Let's go. Ooh, shaky Peugeot. Don't like that.
What's wrong with a Peugeot? Driver error.
Pull up on the right, we're back rolling.
We're back rolling.
Via Costa. Back rolling, last maneuver, the absolute easiest maneuver. This is the dream. This is what you want to get on your driving test because it's so easy. Pull up on the right.
Pull up on the right.
Oh, thanks, that guy's letting me go. So what the examiner's gonna do while you're driving is just ask you to pull up in a safe place on the right. So ask me.
So in a safe place, I'd like you to pull up somewhere on the right, please.
All right, cool. So I'm going to check my mirrors, signal to the right, and it's just the same as pulling up on the left, except you're on the right. Obviously, if there's a car coming towards you, you let them go first and get yourself nice and close to the curb, preferably perfectly parallel. So all you have to do next is reverse back 2 car spaces in a straight line.
So what I'd like you to do now is reverse back approximately 2 car lengths, staying relatively straight and parallel to the curb. Carry on when you're ready, please.
So what I'm going to do is, I've checked my mirror. I can see my car and my curb is perfectly parallel. So I don't need to mess about with any steering. I'm just going to reverse back and keep wicked observation. I'm checking my mirror to make sure I'm still nice and parallel, but I'm not staring at it. I know I'm parallel. Unless I do some steering, I'm going to stay parallel. That's about 2 car lengths?
Yeah.
So if you keep reversing, the examiner will say that's enough. That's all right, thanks, stop. But you can stop yourself after about 2. Yep. Happy with that?
Yeah, happy with that. I don't think that there's a need for me to demonstrate that. I don't think I'll be able to do it any better than you, and I've already won, so.
You haven't won? Yeah, no. There's no other methods of doing that. You just get close to the curb, you reverse back. It's like, that's the dream.
It's the dream.
If you get this, you're laughing. You don't have to do any other parking. That's a manoeuvre, a legit manoeuvre on your driving test.
And 9 times out of 10, the examiner has probably already seen an opportunity for you to pull up on the right. So
definitely,
they've got a good idea of where you're going to choose as well.
Or they know that the road that you're on has a good opportunity to pull up on the right somewhere. What's a safe space mean? If they say pull up on the right in a safe space like you did?
You don't want to block driveways. You want to be in possibly a designated bay, not on lines. Or blocking driveways.
Yeah, there's no bays curbs on this road, which means that you could park anywhere down it except for on a drop curb where the driveway is. Cool. Well, that's it. Guys, who won? Who's the better driver, parker, all-round human being, me or Laura? Get in the comments, let us know your thoughts, and let us know if your instructor teaches you anything different.
That was fun. And I won. I'm going to win.
Guys, you got my back. I know you do. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to the channel. Hit the notification bell so that YouTube knows that we are awesome and recommends it to other people as well.
And don't forget to vote Laura to win.
See you in the next video. Peace. And turn quickly and briskly into the bay. Once I'm parallel.
You're over on that side. You're so over that line.
Oh, we're going to do that again.
1-0! 1-0!
Obviously,
1-0.
That's not going to go in the video.
And then you're going to hit the fucking curb.
That was definitely more like 2:30, 2:30.
I can't talk. Let me go back to there.
Tight margins. 2 turns to the right.